Usage Scenario 4. Two-layer network with IP surveillance solution, layer 3 switch is core. In the following slides, we will introduce the last scenario and talk about how to implement and configure Usage Scenario 4 Auto Surveillance Network. Usage Scenario 4 is a two-layer switched network with a D-Link layer 3 switch as the core layer switch and Smart 3 switches as the access layer switches, as shown in the diagram. This diagram shows the connections, configurations, and connected ports of the switches, network cameras, and other components. Please note that the links between the Layer 3 managed switch and the Smart 3 switch are trunk lines with tagged ports, because they have to carry multiple VLANs. The VMS server is connected to the Smart 3 switch 1, which is connected to the Layer 3 managed switch. The D-Link network cameras and the VMS clients are connected to Smart 3 switches 2 and 3, which is then connected to the Layer 3 managed switch as well. In small and medium-sized business network environments, with a Layer 3 switch as the core switch, it's a common practice to plan VLANs for different functional groups. So in this usage scenario, we plan VLANs and assign IP addresses as follows. VLAN 4094 is the auto surveillance VLAN on the client side. 192.168.1.0/24 is assigned to it. By default, the Smart 3 switch uses 4094 as the VLAN ID for the auto surveillance VLAN. You can change the value as we do for the VMS server VLAN here. Of course, you can use 4094 as well. It's another design concept. We use another VLAN ID as an example in a routing network environment. VLAN 100 is the auto surveillance VLAN for the VMS server. 192.168.100.0/24 is assigned to it. VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 are office VLANs. 192.168.10.0/24 and 192.168.20.0/24 are assigned to them, respectively. Refer to the VLAN and IP table for details. For the Layer 3 managed switch, the following configurations are required. First, VLAN configuration and addition of tagged ports to VLANs. Remove default VLAN and add tagged port 20, 21, 22 to VLAN 10, VLAN 20, and VLAN 100, and VLAN 4094, respectively. Second, the IP configuration for each of the VLAN interfaces. Third, DHCP relay configuration. Assume the existing DHCP servers are properly configured. Log in and enter the Layer 3 managed switch and enter the web management console. Here, we use DGS 3627 as an example. Go to L2 Features, VLAN, Static VLAN Entries, and in the right panel, click Modify. Remove all ports from the default VLAN except for the port you use to configure the switch. Here we use port 1. Click None for those ports, and click Apply to apply the configuration. Click Add to add VLAN 10. Input 10 as the VID, and V10 as the VLAN name. Configure the tag port for port 22 and click Apply to apply the configuration. Follow the same steps for VLAN 20, VLAN 100, and VLAN 4094, but configure the tag port for port 21 for V20, port 20 for ASV100, and port 21 and 22 for ASV4094, as shown in the diagram. Remember to click Apply to apply the configuration. You can verify the result in Current Static VLAN Entries table. Then go to L3 Features, Interface Settings, IPv4 Interface Settings to configure the IP addresses for each of the VLAN interfaces. Click Add and fill the required information for VLAN 10, 20, 100, and 4094 in all fields based on the VLAN and IP table. Click Apply to apply the configuration. Finally, configure the DHCP relay feature to redirect the client DHCP request to the existing DHCP servers. Go to Administration, DHCP/BootPRelay, DHCP/BootPRelay Global Settings, to enable the DHCP relay state. Click Apply to apply the setting. Then go to DHCP/BootPRelay Interface Settings. Input the interface name where the DHCP server is located. Input the server IP address and click Add to apply the setting. You have now completed the configuration of the Layer 3 managed switch. Let's go on to configure the Smart 3 switch. For the Smart 3 switches, the following configurations are required. First, enable the Auto Surveillance VLAN feature and add the VMS server and VMS client MAC addresses to user-defined MAC settings in the Smart 3 switch web management console. Second, configure VLAN and add tagged ports to VLANs. Enable Auto Surveillance VLAN feature in the Auto Surveillance VLAN settings page of Smart 3 switch 1. Before applying the configuration, change VLAN ID to 100 and input 10 in the tagged plink/downlink port field. Click Apply to apply the setting. Under the user-defined MAC settings, select Video Management Server for component type. Input Demo VMS Server for description and input VMS Server MAC address. Click Add and you will see an entry in the table below. Repeat the steps to enable Auto Surveillance VLAN for Smart 3 Switch 2, but do not change VLAN ID. Under the user-defined MAC settings, select VMS Client/Remote Viewer for component type. Input Demo VMS Client for description and input VMS Client MAC address. Click Add and you will see an entry in the table below. For Smart 3 Switch 3, simply follow the same steps as you did for Switch 2 to enable the Auto Surveillance VLAN feature. Remove all ports from default VLAN for all Smart 3 switches. Go to Configuration, 802.1Q VLAN. Click VID 1 Hyperlink and click Not Member for all ports. Apply the configuration by clicking Apply. In Smart 3 Switch 2, go to 802.1Q VLAN setting page and add a new VID. Input 20 for VID and V20 for VLAN name. Click Untagged under port 5 and click Apply to apply the configuration. Follow the same steps for the Smart 3 Switch 3 to add VLAN 10. Remember to save the configuration for all three switches when done. After the configuration is done, the network cameras, the VMS server, and the VMS client are recognized by the Smart 3 switch automatically and will be put in the Auto Surveillance VLAN. Network traffic coming from those devices will have the priority value set to high. So let's verify the configuration through the following steps. First, verify the network connectivity of each components by using the ping command. Here, we test it from the VMS server to the VMS client as an example. Bring up the Windows command prompt and issue ping IP to the destination hosts. If you see the reply from the destination IP address, here 192.168.1.5, the network connection is fine. Otherwise, you have to troubleshoot network connection issues. Consult your D-Link representative for help. Second, verify the VMS server and the VMS client to see if live view, playback or remote live view, and remote playback can be conducted. In the above, we introduced the fourth Auto Surveillance VLAN scenario and how you can implement and configure its network. Okay, we've introduced what Auto Surveillance VLAN is and how it works. And we also show you four usage scenarios that you can apply to your business network, regardless if you have a simple or a complex network environment. After this comprehensive learning, we believe you can make the most of D-Link Auto Surveillance VLAN solution to simplify your management and secure your business.